Hello everyone, good morning and welcome to Umam TV. Today we have yet another powerful story and she is Asmita Javdekar. She is the founder and creative nurturer of Aatman and she has a very lovely journey to share with us. Hi, hi. Asmita.
Hi Shweta.
So how did this all start for you?
Shweta, you know, I was married very early. So around 23 years of age, I finished my engineering. I did my electronics and telecommunication. And before giving my BE exam, the last year final year exam, arranged marriage setup was ready and my parents had found someone for me. And of course I met him and I liked him. And immediately after giving my exam, I got married. Okay, so 22 and a half I was married. Before 23 and a half, I had my first daughter. So life got busy. I got busy with kids, family, and beyond the point when the little one, the second one was born, after a few years, I realized that I haven't done anything with my life. I'm an engineer, I have a good degree, and I don't do anything. And it just didn't feel right. So I joined my family business, went into construction. And what I realized is, I was doing it, maybe to prove to the world that I need to do something, but I didn't have my heart in it. So I was constantly looking for things. I used to constantly try and learn something. So I studied photography, I did French, and every time I genuinely felt that this is it. I'm going to be like a superstar in what I'm doing. And it didn't really work.
I quite like that. Yeah. Be a superstar in whatever I
every time. Every
please
time.
Please note this, Homer.
So you know how, even as a child, when I used to watch movies, I used to always imagine myself as the hero. Okay. Always. So always winning in life.
And
So one odd day when I was at my mother's house, and my mother, she hails from a royal family, so she has a very keen interest in jewelry. So she used to always keep making jewelry for my sister and me. We grew up in Pune, we went to St. Mary's school, we never ended up wearing any of the jewelry she made for us. We were not interested in gold. So we used to end up wearing, you know, those little knickknacks of the road and junk jewelry, the silverware.
FC road ones.
Yeah, like really.
We are on the FC road.
And I remember my Ajji getting so mad at us, But that's how we were and that's what we liked wearing. So eventually, after my sister and I got married, my mother started traveling a lot. And from all her travels, she used to curate such, you know, like really interesting stuff from wherever that she went. And eventually, she was so close to all the jewelers in Lakshmi Road that she used to get silver stuff made for us from them. Whenever we ever donned whatever that she had created or made, they were like compliments galore. And I remember as a child, you know, my mom used to always say, if we had an education like y'all, if we went to school like yours, then just imagine where I would be right now. So one odd day when I was at her house, I was seeing the collection that she had assembled together, put together. I said, Mom, this is fab. I mean, you're so talented. I'm going to launch you as an entrepreneur. You're 54 years old today, but that's it.
Oh, it's an impressive thing.
And that was really the, you know, fire starter for Aatman. That's about it. And social media was pretty new at that time. I was very active because I had lots of time on hand. So I used to keep writing. I had just studied photography. So I used to keep clicking. And I used to feel that I'm really good at photography. Not that I am. It's just that it was new.
But as you feel, wow.
I truly felt. And I started clicking her stuff and putting it up on Facebook. That's how we started. I decided we have a little small showcase. Invite friends and family. The showcase started at 10 o'clock in the morning. By 2 o'clock in the afternoon, we didn't have a single piece left. And that was the birth of Aatman. That's how we started off.
Very beautiful. So a woman inspired a woman.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
So how is your journey now? I believe you are focused on some other areas of work as well.
So the idea was to prove myself. To maybe launch my mother as an entrepreneur, but somewhere I had the desire to showcase my talent, my potential to the world, to make money. I've always come from both the families, my maternal as well as the family I'm married into, from a place of abundance. So there's not something where, you know, I have to go out and work to earn money. That is not the criteria. But somewhere every woman has this desire that she needs to make something of her own. And
make
my desire, absolute, it absolutely stemmed from there. I wanted to make my own money, as simple as that. So Aatman started like that. Luckily, being an engineer, I had a lot of friends who helped me set up the website. And we got into e-commerce at the right time. Now, it was just the beginning of e-commerce in India, social media picking up. I always had this desire to put out stories in front of the world. And it all came together. So it was a confluence of soulful stories, of beautiful jewelry, and really this innate desire of a woman to go out and prove. And I put in my heart and soul and everything that I had into this brand the last 5 years. That's all that I have done. I've worked, I've written stories, I've created memories, beautiful jewelry. So jewelry was a medium, honestly.
I can see on your face, you're so happy.
Jewelry was a medium. It could have been anything else, but that was how the stories were getting translated. And the whole idea was to talk about, you know, positivity, happiness, and a journey more than anything else. So maybe, you know, somewhere, maybe 6 months back, something snapped within. And I said, I can't do jewelry anymore. I'm saturated. And whatever I had to learn and become in this journey, I have already become. Maybe it's time to take a detour, change my direction. So people are really scared right now. I get messages every single day. Are you closing Aatman? What is happening? Where is it going? Please don't do it. We love your brand. Aatman is not going to shut ever because it's a philosophy.
And it's from heart.
It's absolutely Aatman. From the heart. So it's just going to metamorphose into something which goes beyond just trading, beyond business. Because I have come to a stage where I don't need to prove anything to anyone. It's my journey. And my journey where I want to be a part or a catalyst catalyst for inspiration, for stories, for happiness, and for positivity. I truly believe, you know, I've been blessed so much in my life. I've really, you know, as a child, it was programmed into me that you're a blessed child, you're a lucky child, you're a happy-go-lucky person. And I kept believing that all my life. And somehow, when you grow older,
as well.
Thank you. When you grow older, you realize that if you have so much, maybe God's will is for you to make someone else feel the same. So that's where my journey is heading now.
Very beautiful. Yeah. And I'm truly touched the way she has got inspired from her mom, the way she has carried on that inspiration through Aatman is truly, truly amazing. So what's your inspiring message for all our moms watching you out there?
Okay. You know what? I think each one of us has our own journey. And honestly, I can't give you an advice to be a good mother or to be a good entrepreneur. Everyone has their own journey. I have mine. You have yours. Celebrate your journey, okay? No matter what it is. For every woman, she plays multiple roles. Some roles, you're awesome at. Some roles, not so much. Don't be hard on yourself. Enjoy the process. We often, you know, work very hard hoping for something to happen in the future. Honestly, work for today. You never know what's going to happen tomorrow. Just work for today. Enjoy the moment. Give as much as you can, gather as many people, be a nice ecosystem, create this ecosystem where you can celebrate life and you can give back as well. So that's about it.
Oh, beautiful. I think I don't have to say anything now. We should just end on these beautiful lines. I truly thank you, Asmita, for this wonderful story sharing with us, and we wish you all the luck for the future and your other ventures.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Stay tuned with Mom TV. We'll see you later.
Thank you.